Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. Who doesn't like a cookie, especially when it's my double chocolate cookie? We're going to get started right away. I'm going to begin to cream some sweet butter. This is regular unsalted butter, which is actually the best type for baking. And into the butter, I'm going to add in 2/3 of a cup of brown sugar. And 1 cup of pure cane sugar. And we want to let the butter and the sugar cream up nice and light. We'll add in 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And while the butter and the sugar is creaming, I'll begin to measure out my flour. And that'll be 2 1/4 cups of flour. And 1/4 cup of flour, so 2 1/4 cups of flour. And to the flour, we want to add the cocoa powder. Now the cocoa powder will go right into the flour because we want to be able to break up any lumps that are in the cocoa powder. Besides, we want to be able to have the cocoa well blended and well distributed when it goes into the creamed butter and sugar. Now it's always a good idea to stop the sugar and the butter, or anytime you're creaming, and just scrape the bowl down. Scrape all the way down to the bottom, and at the same time, just scrape off any of the butter or sugar clumps that might be on the beater or the paddle. So now I'll add in pecans. I'll add in 1 cup of pecans. Now you can do it 2 ways. You can add the pecans in at this stage, or you can even chop them down a little bit, but I can let the machine actually do the work for me. So I'll let the pecans break up within the butter and the sugar. Okay, the butter and sugar, when it's nice and light and creamy, then it's going to be time to add in the flour. All the flour can be added in at once. It doesn't have to be added in several stages. And then you want to make sure when you start the mixer now, you kind of pulse it a little bit. You want to allow the flour to get absorbed in by a little of the butter and the sugar. Okay, while that's being added, we're going to add in 2 eggs. But we want to beat our eggs slightly. Break them up. So they'll mix into the cookie dough much easier. We turn the machine back on. Very low speed at this time, because now we just want all the ingredients to finish blending in. We don't want it to overmix too much, otherwise that'll make for a tougher cookie. Add in the baking soda, which is going to enrichen the cocoa powder and make it a much more darker cookie. I'll add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla with about 3 tablespoons of milk. And now comes the fabulous chocolate part. Just break up some chocolate pieces. About 1 cup of chocolate. And this is exactly the way the batter should look. Nice and creamy, soft, and the only lumps that are going to be in there is chocolate and pecans. Okay, so we're going to pan these up and bake them in a 350-degree oven for about 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, on my sheet pan I have parchment paper, which is going to help then not stick to a pan, then there's no need for pre-greasing. But a good tip to keep the parchment paper from sliding around is just take the tiniest dab of the batter from the cookie dough and then press it down, and it'll keep the batter adhered. Now, the easiest way to do it is to scoop it with an ice cream scoop. And just pile it up on the pan. You could use two spoons, that works as well. But I kind of like using an ice cream scoop. It helps me gauge as far as the size of the cookies. The size of the cookies just really depends upon your own personal taste. You can make these mini, or you can make them much larger, depending upon how you're serving them. So now we'll take them and put them in a 350 degree oven for about 8 minutes, and then we'll check them. Okay, like I said, about 8 minutes in, we're checking the cookies to see how they are. And the way you can test if a cookie is done, if it starts to slide a little bit in its spot, it's ready. You don't want to let it overbake, and even while it's on the hot sheet pan or cookie sheet, it's still continuing to bake. So while we let them rest just about a minute, I'll put the other pan in the oven. Once they are cool, then you can transfer them to a wire screen. So they have actually a chance to air dry. There's still a little bit of humidity inside of a cookie, and you want them to be nice and crisp or nice and chewy. And this is going to allow the air to totally dry out the cookie. You leave them like this for about 30 minutes. That's if you don't jump into a big glass of milk and try them right away. Now once the double chocolate cookies have had a chance to fully dry, you can set them up on your platter. And even if they're still a little warm, you can get a nice glass of milk. So my double chocolate cookies, great way to have a nice sweet treat at the end of the meal. And you might even want to share it with some friends. It's a good idea. Make a goodie bag. And to cap it off, my classic double chocolate pecan cookies. I'm George Hirsch. If I can do it, you can do it. Double chocolate's the way to go.